So with Star Wars The Last Jedi hitting theaters in just a few weeks, I, along with many others, will be rewatching The Force Awakens in preparation. And in addition to all the nostalgic moments and exciting highlights of The Force Awakens, I will especially be looking forward to rewatching my favorite scene in the movie. No, not that one, or that one, or that one. But very close. No, my favorite scene takes place on Starkiller Base, where Kylo Ren interrogates Rey in order to discover the map to the location of Luke Skywalker. This scene, one of the simplest in the entire movie, has kept me closely drawn into the film ever since I saw it for the first time. It's simultaneously intense and emotional, and manages to unveil a few surprises in just 3 minutes. I already knew what Adam Driver's face looked like prior to the film's release, and the scene's execution alone still managed to make my gut drop the moment he takes his helmet off. So, as I naturally wonder why I like the films I like, I sought to understand why I enjoy watching this scene, analyzing it shot for shot. The first bullet point to begin this essay starts with the director himself, J.J. Abrams. It comes as no surprise that he draws much of his inspiration from Steven Spielberg. From their curly hair and short stature to their own films in and of themselves, many comparisons can be made. But the most notable similarity between the two, and where I believe Abrams is inspired most, is their use of long takes and minimal camera setups. Instead of just setting up a shot, rolling the camera, moving the camera somewhere else, and repeating the process, Abrams likes to stage his scenes in a way that saves time and keeps them interesting. Take this shot for example. It's all one take, but the camera is framed on multiple things at a time, showing us where we are and what's happening. Abrams does this by placing the camera on a dolly or crane and swapping lenses between shots if needed. Now let's take a look at the scene. Since it's common knowledge to start out wide and move closer, I assume that this was the first angle that was shot. From there, we move closer into a two-shot, and then to our over-the-shoulders. From each of these angles, the camera is on a dolly, and though it doesn't always move, having your camera on wheels makes it easier when you have to get a variety of shots in just a day. You can tell that the following angles were from the same take based on how much of the actors we see and the distortion of the lens. The camera dollies forward and backward, allowing us to move as the scene progresses and for the film's crew to get as much coverage as they can. This angle, an over-the-shoulder, was most likely the third setup. Once again, the following shots were all captured on the same lens, but by moving the camera, as well as your actors, your medium shot can become a close-up. The same technique is used for this angle, which is likely to be the fourth setup. Again, notice the distortion of the lens as it moves forward. It shoots at a wider angle, which makes us feel extremely close to Rey at the end of the scene. But I bet you're wondering, why would they shoot the end of the scene first? Well, it might make more sense to shoot your scenes in chronological order, but technically the opposite makes more sense on set, starting with a wider lens and then swapping it for one that zooms in further. Next is a closer shot from the same angle. Just like the over-the-shoulder shots of Adam Driver, the camera slowly pushes in as we learn more about Rey's ability to use the Force. And now, we can shoot the beginning.
Where am I?
So that covers the overall scene composition, but there are even more minute tasks that accompany the direction of a film. Let's go back to the two-shot. Notice the way Kylo Ren holds his hand. By viewing this one frame, we can tell that he assumes his interrogation of Rey is going to come easy, that he doesn't even have to try. But when Rey starts to fight back, his hand is reaching out aggressively, fighting just as hard as his opponent. This next detail went unnoticed the first 4 times I saw The Force Awakens in theaters, but dawned on me as I watched this one scene over and over. We know that Kylo Ren uses the Force to read Rey's mind, but there's something different about the second time it happens. Watch the edges of the frame. The second Kylo Ren holds his hand up to Rey's head, the camera begins to move in circular motions, putting us in her position of unease or of being manipulated. Techniques like these elevate a movie's quality, so that rather than watching a standard blockbuster, we experience an exceptional one. And just like that, with a few reshoots after film has wrapped, and a couple of inserts, you have your scene.